If you're like most of us, you actually need more of your email list to open and read your emails, but you struggle with how to make that happen. I'm going to walk you through a simple three-step process that increases your email open rates, getting more of your email list to open and to read your emails. Maybe you've tried those guaranteed subject lines, or even hiring a copywriter, or even downloaded some email templates that are guaranteed to make your emails amazing. Maybe you've even thought of outsourcing your email because it's just a constant struggle and you have better things you should be doing. But there's a problem. All those things that you've tried, they're all hacks. Hacks are great for a one-off or a one-hit wonder, but you cannot hack long-term success. And when it comes to outsourcing, well, email is the reigning king of conversions. In other words, even at horrible email open rates of say 15 to 20%, you're still getting 15 to 20 people out of 100 on your email list to see what you're sending. But if you're on social media, you'll get at most 1.4%. That's Instagram, or even worse, 0.9%, that's Facebook, or even worse than that, 0.45%, that is Twitter, which means that on social, you're getting 1 out of 100 people to see your posts. And when this all comes down to outsourcing, why would you outsource the most important money-making aspect of your business to someone who does not know your business? That's a problem. Outsourcing sales emails, sure. But when you're talking about consistent engagement and connecting with your people, that is a whole different story. You need your emails opened and read. It's important. I'm going to show you and share with you three simple, easy, and sustainable things that you can do that will increase your email open rates and rather quickly, I might add. Who am I? I'm Christina Etheridge, and I help online entrepreneurs double their email open rates. Or as I like to say, I help you reach your people. I help you make more money so that you can change the world. And if you're interested in getting other videos just like this, getting your email list opened and read, that's what I focus on here on this channel. So hit the subscribe button and join me. Let's dive in. In reality, getting people to open and read and continue to open and read your emails is actually rather simple. Here are the three steps. Number one, you have to be consistent. Number two, you have to be authentic. Number three, you have to be valuable. Yeah. But what do I mean? What does that look like? Why these things? Well, that's what I'm going to talk with you about today. So first of all, be consistent. Why on earth would you need to be consistent? Because the email algorithms look at that consistency to determine where you go when they sort you. Do you go into spam? Do you go into promotions? Or do you go into the inbox? Your consistency is a key to your ability to get into the inbox and to get open and get read. Also, if you do the same day, same time, week in and week out, that means being consistent means same day, same time, week in and week out, you have people begin to show up for you. It trains your readers. It trains your people. Think of TV shows. Think of, I know that we're in a binge society. I know for me personally, I tend to wait until the entire series is out before I watch it. So like The Mandalorian, I really had to stay off of social media when season 2 started coming out because I wasn't willing to wait a week between each episode. So I waited until all 8 episodes were done and then watched it immediately. Like we watched it the day the 8th episode came out. But that's the person I am. However, most of society, which is why I had to keep myself off of social, will watch things the minute they come out, and they are trained. I mean, if you remember, if you're like the Friends generation, which is what I am, every Thursday night, 8 o'clock on the Peacock channel, that's what it was. That's what we watched. We're used to consistency. The podcasts that you watch, the radio show or listen to, the radio shows that you listen to here on YouTube, consistency. We're used to consistency. So your weekly email, you should have a weekly email that goes out the same day, same time, week in and week out. That again, it helps the algorithms. Like I said, it trains your readers and it creates a habit for you because one of the biggest struggles that we have is actually being consistent. All right. So be consistent. That is a big piece of this puzzle. When you're consistent, it helps you get your emails open and read. Number two is be authentic. All right. Authentic. Awesome. What do I mean? I mean, you need to be you. That means that the you that you are at home is the same you that shows up in the email, or the same you that shows up on Instagram, or the same you that shows up on YouTube. You're you. You. Okay, some of us put a mask on. We must wear a suit whenever we go on stage, or we must put full makeup on, whatever. I am me. This is who I am. I wear mascara and lipstick. That's it. I don't care if I'm on camera. I don't care if I'm on stage. I don't care if I'm behind a computer screen typing a thing. I'm me. But not only that, where does that relate to? It relates to being you. Talk about you. Not like how awesome you are, but you, be real, be vulnerable, be human, be relatable. In other words, be a real person with real achievements, real struggles, real relationships, real dreams, real desires, real failures, all those real things. In other words, you need to be authentic so that people have a reason to connect with you. Because I don't care what people want to believe, people buy from people. We buy from people. We don't buy from brands. That is why brands, big brands, pay influencers and celebrities, people that other people relate to represent their brand, because they know that people buy from people. And so if you don't start engaging with who you are and showing people who you are, showing people that, I don't know what your passions are, like, you know, I have four boys, all four boys are adopted. We both adopted both internationally and domestically. We traveled the country for a year and a half in our motorhome with our four boys, our four cats, our dog. Had a blast. We move house about every 3 years. It just does. There's funny things that happen in our lives. There are hard things that happen in our lives. You know, I share it. I share these little pieces because those are connection points. People need a real authentic connection point. They need to know that you are you, so that if you're doing things in email and talking with them in email, and then they show up and they purchase your course or your membership or whatever, and it's not you, like you're not the same person, there's going to be a disconnect. You don't want that. You want them to be the same person. And the most amazing compliment that I can ever get when somebody meets me in real life or they see me on video or whatever is that, like, you're you. And I'm like, you're right. I'm me. That's big deal. People need a thing to connect with you. They need a reason to connect with you. That's why you need to be authentic. So be consistent and be authentic. Let's dive into Be Valuable. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button. That is always appreciated. That can let me know how much you like it or not like it. Well, if you want to see more videos like this, then hit the subscribe button. That's what I talk about. It's all about email and how to get more people to open and read your emails. And if you don't want to miss a single video, hit the little bell icon. All right, let's talk about Be Valuable. Be valuable. I know I've heard, I'm always hearing this phrase, give value, give it. I'm like, what the heck? So then people think that giving value is, well, I offered them a course or a workshop. No, that's not giving value. Give value. Be a guide. Be educational. Be generous. Don't sell. Help them with a micro step. Teach. Don't sell. Said that again. Be succinct. Don't sell. Okay, let me clarify what I'm talking about here. When you are valuable, you want to teach people a small micro step in your email. So that means that you want to help them. You want to, if it's a fast thought, if it's a fast, small thing, something that you can give to them or teach them or help them move one microscopic step forward in their journey based around your expertise. That is what being valuable is. You're not going to drive them to something to buy. Your weekly email is all about making a connection. It is your all access pass to getting into the inbox. When you have an email that goes out very consistently, that connects with people, so you're be consistent and connects with people because it's authentic and it teaches them something that's valuable. If you have an email that does those three things, that goes out every single week, same day, same time, they will open it. And they will read it. And that will increase your open rates. Not only that, when you do go to sell and you have a launch or you have a flash sale or whatever it is, those emails are going to be blessed with the reputation that you have created through your weekly connection focused email. So when you are valuable, you don't sell. You help them with a micro step. Don't just promote your blog post. Don't just promote your YouTube video. Don't just promote whatever it is. Actually give them something valuable in their email. You need to do that. So you need to be consistent. You need to be authentic. You need to be valuable. These are important and they are way easier than you think. This does not need to be complicated. We overthink it, overcomplicate it. Like seriously, share a 30-second thing that happened in your life this week as your be authentic piece. Super easy. A 30-second thing that happened, something you learned. Mine tends to be a little bit along the personal development journey because that's the journey that I am on personally. But I also share things like that my kids do or that my husband does or that my cats do or whatever. So people know, like it shares, oh, she has a cat. In fact, I had somebody connect. I had put something in my email about cats and they came on a video and they said, now I hope you have cats. I'm like, oh yes, I have four. And so they were like, oh, okay. So they literally, that was a connection point. They have cats. They were connected with that piece of me and they needed to know that that was real, that I was talking about cats because I really liked them. So I know that's weird. Like, especially if you're like, but I'm selling books or I'm selling, vacations or I'm selling this, right? But people buy from people. And the reason that they will buy what you have to offer is because they connect with you on an authentic, real, personal level. So be consistent, be authentic, be valuable. Those are the three things that you need to include and be on a weekly email in order to get more people to open. Because when these things happen, people open and read your emails. And when they open and read your emails, guess what they do? They buy from you. They become loyal and raving fans of yours. That's what happens. And that's why it is such a big deal to have these three things involved. So do you have any questions about anything that I've shared today? If you do, please put them in the comments below. I am taking your questions. I am making videos from your questions in order to help you out here. And if you have some experience that you'd like to share that you think will help me or anyone else here, please share it. I would love it. And until next time, make today intentional.